So thank you so much for coming to our evening on body politics and the male gaze in the visual, literary and performative arts. We have this evening with Sharmishtha Ray, who's in conversation with Rosalind DeMello. We also have a Lavani performance by Kali Billi Productions. We wanted to use Ravi Verma as a starting point to begin the conversation about male gaze. Quick introduction about Bellevue Salon. It's a unique conversational platform founded by Sharmishtha, who's an artist, a TED fellow, and a curator. Rosalind DeMello is a New Delhi-based freelance writer. Her art reviews and features have been published in Art and Art Plus Auction, Modern Painters, Art India, and Take On Art.
Gender and sexuality is a subject very close to my heart. One of the things that came out immediately, you know, when I was viewing this particular exhibition is the way, this veiled way in which he approaches a female subject. The idea of the male gaze was really theoretical. It was a theoretical way of looking at cinema, looking at the subjects of cinema. But many things haven't changed, you know. Patriarchy has not changed. It's, you know, may have changed its form, but it's something that is really quite dominant. So I just want to show this video in order to understand what we're talking about when we talk about body politics.
Please welcome the Gorilla Girls, everybody. This poster right here. Do women have to be naked to get into the Met Museum? Why is it important to protest to get more women into an art museum?
Well, I mean, every decision, aesthetic decision, has a value behind it. And if all the decisions are being made by the same people, then, you know, the art will never look like the whole of our culture.
Is the art world like more important than other aspects for feminism, or is it merely your focus?
We are artists, so we started out in the art world, but very quickly what we did was invent this way of using facts and humor to twist an issue around and present it in a different way that might change people's minds.
To be very honest, I think right now some of the best art and the best writing is being done by women artists and by women writers who are in their 30s and their 40s, and it's so exciting and it's so invigorating and it's challenging and it's critiquing institutions, it's kind of subverting gender norms, it's puncturing our notions of narrative form, of discourse. A Handbook for My Lover, it is actually a non-fiction memoir.
The history of art production by women is actually, 70 years old? And so is there a need to also tell our story?
Sometimes I envy male artists and male writers because they can write about anything and no one will ever question them. No one will ever ask them the kind of questions that you get asked as a woman.
I have a few slides, kind of the history of art and also the history of just images from advertising that I find kind of interesting and provocative. This is, of course, Raja Ravi Verma, Shakuntala. And it's interesting, this kind of, you know, the old woman in the background is cloaked and she's away from the view, whereas this ideal, fair, beautiful young woman, you know, kind of has the light shining on her. So this is one of the ideas of kind of, this is a framing of the male gaze. So you see the kind of issues being played out. This is Micheline Thomas, a lesbian African-American artist who reappropriates images from art history and reclaims a black body. But also still looking through a lens of desire. I mean, Raja Ravi Verma, and this is Pushpamala N, a feminist Indian artist who has recreated the same image. Pushpamala, this idea of performance. And, you know, Judith Butler, of course, has talked about gender as performance. Hysteria, another category. And it's interesting because in Rosalind's book as well, there are moments of real where you go hysterical. and this is what I see as the alter ego, the Kali, the dark, you know. It's also... And this was, of course, from that very controversial empowerment. And we can really dissect that.
Namaskar. Kya baat hai. So all of you know Lavani. You must have seen Lavani in television, theater, Ganpati Utsav, films, many ways. If you want to understand the true essence of Lavani, you need to understand the artist who performs the Lavani. The first meeting of the Lavani needs to be up close and personal.
मेरे हाथ अपने हाथों में लेकर मोना भाई जब सावित्री को आंख मिचका कर बोली क्या पागल करके छोड़ा या नहीं, तब जाके मैं होश में आकर उनकी हंसी मजाक में शामिल हो पाया।
हमारी अगली मुलाकातों में उन्होंने ढेर सारे गाने हमारे लिए पेश किए, उनकी भाषा में बताया जाए तो खेले।
Thank you.